I am super excited to show you how you can create a clean and simple text animation inside of DaVinci Resolve without using any plugin in a few simple steps. This video is gonna be a step-by-step tutorial, so watch this video till the end and create an awesome looking text animation for your video editing project. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's take a new project and get started. Alright, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 18 edit page, and before we get started we have to do some basic setting as usual. So click on this setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. You can select 4K resolution as well, and now we have to select a frame rate. So in this case I'm using 60 frames per second for a smooth animation, or you can select any frame rate that you like. Here we have the playback frame rate, so let's set the playback frame rate 24 frames per second for faster render preview and click on save. Now I'm going to create this motion graphics inside of this fusion page, so we have to take a new fusion composition. So just go to this media pool, right click on that, click on new fusion composition, you can call it anything. And now set the duration of this composition maybe 6 seconds long, which is good enough for one text reveal. Frame rate 60 and click on create. Now let's drag and drop the fusion composition on the timeline just like that. Set it like this and then go to the fusion page. And here we have the media out node, so just drag this media out to the side for now. And for this animation we need only one viewer, so you can click on the single viewer. And after that let's start by creating a background. So this is the background node. You can simply drag and drop on the flow window, drag this background to the viewer, and here we have the black background. So let's change the color to white. Perfect. And now I'm going to convert this background into a thin line. So we have to attach a rectangle. So this is the rectangle. Let's drag and drop on the flow window. Attach the rectangle with the background. Now we have to create a thin line by adjusting this width and height value. So let's set the width value 0.008 and set the height value 0.35. Perfect. Now I'm going to call it background. So right click on the background, click on rename, or you can also hit F2 on the keyboard. Let's call it line, hit OK. And now we have to create a text, so it's very simple. Let's drag and drop the text node on the flow window, drag the text to the viewer, type anything whatever you want, select your favorite font style. So in this case I'm using Nulshock font style. You can select any font style that you like. Now let's increase the size of the font according to you. I'm going to set the value 0.2. perfect. And then we have to create a split effect, but before that we have to go on this preview window, right click on that, go to guide and turn on the guide, and this is the center line, so we have to split the text from here. It's very simple. Let's take a new background node, and this background is going to be the matte. So hit F2 on the keyboard to rename, call it matte 1. Now drag the matte to the viewer. I'm going to attach the rectangle with this matte. So this is the rectangle. Let's attach the rectangle with the matte, and you can place the matte over here at the center of this frame. So we have to set the round figure value 0.75, which is absolutely perfect. And I'm gonna merge this text with the matte. So let's take a new merge node, connect the yellow background point with this matte and green foreground point with the text. You can arrange the node like this and then drag the merge 1 to the viewer. After that select the merge, go to the inspector window, and here we have the operator. Right now we have the operator over. It means text is over on this black background, but I want to place this foreground inside of the background. So let's change the operator over to in, and now we will get this type of output. Perfect. Now we have to create another part of the text, so it's very simple. Select all the nodes, hit Ctrl C to copy, hit Ctrl V on the keyboard to paste. You can rename it properly, so I'm gonna quickly rename these nodes. Perfect. Let's drag the merge 2 to the viewer, select the rectangle, and let's drag the rectangle mask on the left side, set the center X value 0.25. perfect. And now we have the first part of the text and the second part of the text. Now let's drag and drop the merge node again, and again I'm gonna use this submerge 1 output as a background and this one as a foreground. So let's connect both the outputs and make it single. Now let's drag the merge 3 to the viewer. Perfect. So this is the complete text. Now we have to animate the text. So it's very simple. Just go to on frame number 120, which is equal to 2 seconds according to 60 frame per second. Now select the text, go to layout, right click on center, click on animate and lock the position value as it is. Go to the first text, go to the layout, right click on center, click on animate. You can also click on the diamond button to create the keyframe. And then just go to very first frame of this animation, drag the text on the left hand side and set the round figure value 0. Select the second text, drag the text on the right hand side and set the round figure value 1. Perfect. And we will get this type of output, which is looking very nice. Now let's create another animation. So we have to go 20 frame forward in time from frame number 120. So it should be frame number 140. Let's drag the text up a little bit. Select the second text and drag it down a bit. And then we will get this type of split effect, which is looking very cool. Now let's go to 40 frame forward in time and add a keyframe. Select the second text and do the same thing. And then go to the 20 frame forward in time, which is the frame number 200. Set it to normal. Now select the first text and set the value 0.5, which is the default value. And then just go to on frame number 300, which is equal to 5 seconds. We have to lock the position as it is again. So click on the diamond button, or you can also right click and set key. Select the second text, right click and click on set key. Just go to the end of this animation. Let's drag the text on the right hand side. Set the value 1. Select the first text, drag the text on the left hand side and set the value 0. And finally, we will get this type of animation, which is looking very nice. And then we have to create a smooth animation for the text. So it's very simple. Just go to the spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. Let's check the text one first. Click on the fit button. Select these keyframe, hit S to smooth. Select these two keyframe, hit S to smooth. Or you can also click on this smooth button. And then we have to smooth these keyframe as well. Perfect. After that, highlight this point, hold this handle and create a nice smooth graph just like that. Highlight this point, hold this handle, drag it like this. And do the same thing for the text 2. So just uncheck the text 1, check the text 2 and repeat same process for this. Perfect. Now just close this spline window. And here we have this smooth animation. After that, we have to animate this line. So just drag the line to the viewer. Just go to on frame number 60, which is equal to 1 second. Select the rectangle, right click on height, click on animate and lock the value as it is. Go to on frame number 300, which is equal to 5 seconds. Right click on height, click on set key. Go to the end of this animation, set the height value 0. Go to the very first frame of this animation, set the height value 0. So finally we will get this type of animation. Now just go to the spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. Let's uncheck the text and this time we have to check the rectangle one only. Click on fit button and we have to create a smooth animation. So select these two keyframes, hit S to smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button. Repeat same process for this. Finally we have to create the nice smooth curve just like that. Perfect. And close this spline window. And now we have to merge this line with the main text. So just drag the node over here. Perfect. Let's take a new merge node and I'm going to use this line as a foreground and this one as a background. So connect the yellow point with this and green point with this. Drag the merge forward to the viewer. And now we will get this type of output, which is looking absolutely perfect. And then just select the second text, go to the setting, and here we have the gradient. So click on the gradient and select a nice gradient color. Just like that. And then we have to do some setting with this. So here we have the mapping label. So let's change this to line, and you can change the gradient setting from here, which is the mapping angle. So you can change the mapping angle and set a nice gradient color just like that. And then we have to attach the drop shadow effect. So select the merge, hit Control plus a space bar for search box and search for drop shadow. So this is the drop shadow, hit add button, drag the drop shadow to the viewer. Now let's do some settings. So here we have the shadow strength. Let's reduce the shadow strength and set the value 0.25. Perfect. And then let's attach a transform node just after this drop shadow. Let's drag the transform to the viewer. By using this transform, you can set the scale of the text and position of the text, also the rotation of the text. For now, let's reduce the scale a little bit, just like that. And then finally, we have to merge this merge node with the main output like this, and then go to the edit page. And here we have the text animation, which is looking very nice. Now you can use the text on any background. So it's very simple. You can simply drag and drop the fusion composition on the top layer, and you can import any video or images. So I'm going to use this image for now. Let's click on open, drag the image on the timeline, set it like this, select the image, go to inspector window. Let's increase the scale a little bit. And then just right click on the image, click on new fusion clip. Just hide the top layer and go to the fusion page, and let's make it black and white. So select the media in, add a color corrected node with this, set the saturation value 0 and make it black and white. And here we have the gain. So let's reduce the gain, set the value 0.2. Now we have to animate the image a little bit. So select the color corrector, add a transform node, go to the end of this animation, right click on size, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation. Let's increase the size a little bit. So I'm going to set the value 1.2. Perfect. And now we have a nice and simple zoom out animation. And then go to the edit page, and here we have the animated background. You can close the inspector window, turn on the fusion clip, and here we have the text animation. Turn on the loop button, go to very first frame, and let's have a look. Alright, so that is it for now. I hope you like this video. If you have any question, drop a message on my Instagram or comment down below. And if you are watching this video first time on this channel, please hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.